So that's basically the rundown here. Let me boot up Disco Elysium. Mind your ears. Here's the thing. Didn't remember exactly what at all had happened both in Disco Elysium and Umineko before I left, because more than a week? There's no way. There's no way my brain would remember. But I did just watch like the last 5 minutes of both to remember where we left off. I think I parked myself in front of the old lady who previously had not spoken to us. Maybe she starts talking to us now that we think she might have to do with the drug smuggling. Lori driver, she may or may not be. Where's the game? Is the game gonna pop up? Let's just wait. There we go. Ah, the old systems have to get warmed up, I guess. Yeah. So that's where we're at with here in Disco Elysium. I'll get to Umineko later. So I think I literally parked myself in front of her. And I said, hopefully she has more info, because if not, then I don't know what we're gonna do for this hour. I'm unaware. Let me look back at that thing one time again. New hatted at least twice. Interesting. Okay. I mean, I'm not against it. You guys can't see what I'm looking at or referring to, but it doesn't matter. Okay, so I parked myself in front of her. Previously, she had not been speaking to us. It must be because she had nothing to say, or she just didn't have a quest update to give to us. God, I think I mentioned this at the end of stream, a week ago. It always feels weird. If I take more than like 4 days off stream, coming back, I just gotta like. It just feels so weird. It just feels so weird to be talking into a mic again. You know what I mean? All right, here we go.
The woman still has her eyes fixed on the photograph in her hands. In the background, the radio plays.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'd like to ask some questions.
No response. Wherever this woman is, your words fail to reach her.
All right, I'm gonna snap my fingers in front of her face.
If you want her attention, you may need to be more forceful.
I wasn't ready for those snaps to feel very in my ear. Like, that almost feels like I was attempting to do that for a sec. I'm gonna put that there. Okay. I'm gonna snap my fingers twice then.
Where am I? Who are you?
Like a magician recalling a subject from hypnosis, you've jolted her back to reality. Oh, look at that.
The smile on her face has disappeared, replaced by the wary aspect of a cornered beast.
A cornered beast. Okay, she said, where am I? Who are you? Are you all right, ma'am? You were out.
Never mind. I remember now. I'm still stuck in that traffic jam in the 50s.
She adds with contempt. Now, this is interesting, because I guess I must have been able to speak to her if I would have snapped in front of her face before and woken her out of it. But it just felt, like, very rude to snap in front of someone's face, especially if they are out of it. So that's why I hadn't done it previously. I was like, well, I gotta try it if I'm gonna actually get anything from her at this point. I don't care why she doesn't like the 50s or whatever. Let's ask this. When else would you be then?
Back in Mefka, during the time of the revolution. The side walls and cafes are filled with young people. I was on my way to see a new Boyadeiro picture starring Gabriel Bungaro.
Gabriel Bungaro? Huh.
Until you came along, that is.
She knows Portuguese? Kinship. The look she gives you is accusatory. You know what I'll ask? Who's Gabriel Bungaro?
This is Gabriel Bungaro.
Shows you the photograph in the lavish amber frame. Take a look.
A strikingly handsome man looks straight at you. His head crowned with a wide brim hat. His hair is dark as an oil slick, and his jaw, the most perfectly chiseled thing you've ever seen.
What a hunk.
He was the biggest star of his day. Girls used to faint in the aisles of cinema whenever he came on the screen. And schoolboys used to memorize all his lines.
She leans back, savoring the world she's conjured up.
In all likelihood, it's a world that's only ever existed in her mind.
So I take it you were in Mesk when you were young?
Someone was.
She nods as though her meaning were perfectly clear. Someone? Are these not your memories?
They are someone's memories, boy. What difference does it make if it's me or not?
Alright. She doesn't like me, clearly.
They're beautiful. That is all that matters. Beautiful and true. And they will win. They're coming for this, you know? All of this.
All of what? The world. The present. She seems to derive some bitter pleasure from this strange thought, as if the past will one day wipe the present away, like a tidal wave approaching.
Is that good? As if the past will one day wipe the present away, like a tidal wave approaching. I'm gonna be polite. Take the high road. Sorry to interrupt your dreaming, ma'am.
I wasn't dreaming. I was there, Loman. It was early spring, and the mine behind the Black Sun had just come out. The posters were 20 meters tall. Everything was golden.
Her eyes narrow as she appears to take your measure.
While you, people, were tearing each other apart over your petty little revolution, in Mesk, it was a golden age.
The Republic of Mesk is a massive confederation on the Isola of Mwindi, the world's largest state by territory. It's a petro-state, a constitutional monarchy, and, as of recently, an outcast due to its tilt to the far right.
Okay. I wanted to check how close... Okay. Just wanted to make myself aware of how much XP I have currently. Alright, right. I have some other questions for you. Please, questions.
Why not, Harife? It's not like I have anything better to do in this hellhole.
She settles back against the railing of her motor lorry. Behind her, mountains of memorabilia, photos, and knickknacks line the dashboard. What are you hauling?
Diamonds.
Diamonds? Really?
Of course not. But wouldn't it be marvelous if I was?
Okay, but what are you really hauling?
Whatever stupid things they put in the lorry, I imagine.
So you don't know what you're hauling in your own lorry?
I quit concerning myself with that a long time ago. Besides, I don't drive the lorry for the cargo, if you know what I mean.
She says that as if something narcotic is the real reason.
Besides, I don't drive the lorry for the cargo. Wait, are you get high off driving a lorry?
Oh, it's so much more than a high where I go, Harife. It's low. I go to the bottom.
She closes her eyes in reverie.
Yeah, it's definitely some kick. Some terrible kick. The pail, probably. This pail sounds like it's the shit.
I guess that makes sense. Minding your own business.
Of course it does. What did you expect?
You seem like a woman who knows a thing or two about drugs. I could get straight to the point. Alright, let me do this one. Before I came, you seemed away.
She's just a distracted old woman. We should maybe let her get back to her things.
So he doesn't think she's the lady driver?
You hear that, Loman? I don't think your partner likes you spending too much time with me.
Wait, why is that, Lieutenant?
Nothing. I just don't think she's connected to anything.
Ah, Kim thinks he knows something.
It's because of the pale. He doesn't want your frail mind caught up in it. And this woman has spent time in the pale. A lot of time.
Okay, let's change the subject.
A pale dream is what it is.
She nods her head according to a rhythm known only to her, staring at the photo in her hands. Alright, are you the lady driver?
Did you just call me a lady, Harifa?
She clearly doesn't think she's a lady. Don't repeat it.
Okay. I was told of a woman driver. You're the only woman here.
I'm not that either, Harifa. I've gone too far from it all to remember what was between my legs. It doesn't work like that on the long haul.
So you're not the driver everyone is terrified of?
I'm only terrifying to small children and to those who used to know me.
Yeah, it's not her. Believe me.
Well, why are you scared of the people who used to know you?
Because they can no longer recognize the person I once was.
Then who is the female driver I was told of?
How should I know? Do I look like I spend a lot of time with the other commoners sniffing around when I have my movies to go to?
Alright, you said long haul, that's...
The big ones, the trucks. There's no women and men there, it's all just...
She hums along as if to a track on repeat.
In the middle of this town, there's a ghostly motorway. It takes all the people where they want to stay.
In the background, a quiet song seeps from her cabin into the air. You don't hear any vocals.
That's all I need to know. Thanks.
Awesome.
The woman stares at you, her mind elsewhere now, on other matters. Alright, thank you for now.
Yes, go. Enough jamboree. I need to get back to Mesky.
Her voice trails off. Well, what the hell?
Yes?
Alright. Okay. Well. Alright. Okay. So there's... apparently some other woman driver... somewhere. He wouldn't know. Would he possibly know? I like him. I like him well enough. He doesn't give me too much shit.
How can I help you?
He looks at you with soft and hazy eyes. Oh wait, no. Okay, maybe he doesn't know. Who else would... Everett? Maybe probably knows? Might know? Since I'm here, I'll just check and make sure he doesn't have an answer for me.
Your race descent has temporarily halted, but you will fall again.
Okay. I only know so many women, you know? The Rolodex of women, that my character knows is not vast, unfortunately. Alright, I'll go see, just so I'm doing my due diligence here, I'll go see if my friend over here knows or has any info, because the quest says find out who's a lady driver. And the people who the only people who may know all the drivers
Mr. Dubois, every worker, member of the board. How How can I help you today?
I don't think it's in here. Can we go over a few details concerning the murder again?
Most certainly, Harry. By all means, Harry. What's on your mind?
Okay. Well, it was worth a shot, I think. Can I fast travel? Damn. All right. It wouldn't possibly be like the woman. Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, I feel a sneeze. Yeah. Excuse me. It wouldn't possibly be the woman who's currently in the Whirling in Rags, would it? It wouldn't, would it? Because the thing is, once you start going out like this way, there's no one out here really concerned about the situations up here. You know what I mean? Like, it all doesn't matter. All that doesn't matter to them. So you have to find someone in it. You gotta find someone in the... Man, it's been forever since I've heard this. This feels like a long shot, honestly.
I've got nothing to say to you. Why are you wasting your time?
The Hardy girl is a different thing than the thing I'm currently trying to find out, I'm pretty sure. Are you the Hardy girl?
I am not.
She says dryly.
You could be Liz. You could be anything. You could even be a mod.
Even a mod? Glenn, I went to law school. I am an attorney.
He's right. With a face like that, she could be on the cover of Le Debutante International.
Alright, well, number one, I don't like. Get a grip, Glenn. She went to law school.
So fucking what? Lots of models are actually really smart people, fuckwad.
No, Glenn. They aren't.
Got him. Her tone is cold and uninvolved.
This didn't change her opinion of you.
Damn it.
It's not her. She's not a Hardy girl. Definitely.
Alright, maybe we'll talk later then.
Hi again, gendarme. Bye-bye, gendarme.
Gendarme. Who is this man just chilling again? He just says it's all about money or something. Well then who else? Find out who's the lady driver and where's her lorry. So there are three drivers at the intersection. Talk to them. One of them must know something about the drug trade. Three drivers? I must have not talked to all three drivers. There's the old lady I just talked to. There's the racist one. And then him? Did I not talk to this one? Or do I have to go
now
talk?
It's turning into a kind of a snow limbo.
Oh, here we go. Maybe I didn't talk
to him.
What's
on your mind?
I heard that one of the drivers is a woman, but I don't think she's here. Do you know this lady driver?
I don't want to talk about that.
He shifts around, suddenly uncomfortable, then looks away. Why? Do you know something? What is it?
Man, I was hoping it isn't gonna be her. All I can say is, she isn't around here anymore. She isn't some evil drug trafficker. And I don't know where she is.
Who is she to you?
A friend? An acquaintance? I don't know. She was the only person in this damn jam I could talk to. She's someone I don't want to rat out to the law, okay?
I get it. I get it. I hate that I'm a cop as well. Who is this person? What's her name?
Thank God I don't know. People here call her the Lady Driver. She kept her name a secret. From me too. Now I see why.
What does she look like?
A youngish woman. Gruff, but in a cool way.
What color hair?
Blue and violet. Dyed. It was violet when she got here. Blue before she went.
Then she may have dyed it again.
I don't like the tone of the number one response. When did she leave?
Damn, I don't want to... Please just let it go. Whatever she did, it can't be that bad. She's not a bad person. I know that much.
We can't just let it go. It's part of a police investigation.
That's how it always is with you, isn't it? All part of the investigation. The girl's troubled. If you hunt her down, she may not survive it. I can't have that on my conscience.
It won't come to that. We won't pursue her on this. This is information only.
I don't believe you.
believe us. It really is.
I just can't, man. I'm not naive.
Alright, you said she's troubled. How?
She's got the darkness in her.
Oh.
That young person's darkness when you think it's all over. And you're looking for a way out.
Oh. Oh, this is unfortunate. I was over here making darkness jokes.
She shared this with you?
Yes. Which is why I don't want to snitch on her.
It's not snitching. It's just a few questions.
It's snitching, man. I know what it is.
I was told everyone's afraid of her. You're not?
I heard the rumors. I saw the other drivers looking at me strange when we talked. And she told me, too, that she's had a violent life. But I wasn't afraid of her. More like for her.
Did this violent life include drug trafficking?
Well, it looks like it did now. But we didn't talk about that. We talked about life, you know? She talked about her mind.
Hold on. Her mind?
The way it worked. The trouble it was giving her.
When she left, did she leave her lorry behind?
Fuck, man. Go grill someone else with these questions.
No, okay? You're the last person.
There are plenty of drivers here who couldn't stand her or were afraid of her. They'd be more than happy to rat her out.
He's right. There are other options. The raceman, for one. Wait, this guy says they're friends. Then, acquaintances. And he's okay with others ratting her out. Push Tommy and it will break his heart. And his spirit. Don't expect you to be pals. Now is not the time to focus on feelings. You need that info, son. It's right here. The answer is right here. You just need to ask him. Come on, do it.
Oh my god, there's so many inner voices here on this one. Force Tommy's just suspect? So you're all right with others ratting her out, you just don't want your hands dirty?
Fine. I don't want to be a butcher. And I don't want to be a knight either. I just want to be a person who can sleep at night. A little fame wouldn't hurt too.
You know what? Fine. I'll drop the matter for now.
Thank you, friend. Wow, this makes me feel like I should pick up smoking again. Would help with my rhymes, too.
Alright, that's all for now. Bye. Alright, I'm gonna... You know what? Fuck the guy up here. I'll go fucking... pressure him.
Looking for something, aunt? Come to tell me to fuck off again?
Alright, I know you've been giving me the runaround. Fess up. Where's the lady driver?
I don't know what you're talking about.
First, you knew Se Lang didn't do it.
He did something. He stole his employer's goods and another lorryman's job. You should be thankful for the tip.
He grins, a wide smile. Then why are you smirking?
Listen up, fuckwits. You don't scare me. You cops don't run Revachal West. You don't run Martinez. You don't run anything.
Just tell me who the goddamn lady driver is.
You're all bark and no bite. The real dogs are up in Jamrock. Everyone knows that.
You mean La Puta Madre?
A legendary.
La Puta Madre?
In a good way. Crime boss from Jamrock. Controls what is probably the most powerful organized crime outfit in Revachal West. Looks like the lieutenant has a plan. Let him do this.
Oh, I'm gonna let Kim cook.
Yeah, him.
I'm gonna cross my arms and nod.
Then I presume you are familiar with his peonies.
Yeah, they're his little bitches. He's got them all over the unions.
His little bitches has got them all over the unions. Okay.
Not just the unions. He has peonies everywhere. Some say he even has them in the RCM. Dirty fucking peonies who do anything for him. Multi-ethnic drug addicts.
The lieutenant adopts a rodentine quality. Be cool, sire. He's getting into this.
Say nothing.
You're not peonies. You wouldn't be investigating a drug thing if you were.
No, of course not. We are not peonies. But if we were, and one of Madre's drivers were to be stealing from him, then it's a good peonies job to find out who that is.
He's surprisingly good at this. Not bad at all. Look at him lurching.
Look at Kim go!
It's not a hard job. It won't take a long time. It won't make Padre Madre angry. But a stupid fucking wrist is just standing in the way, protecting this fucking thief.
I'm not scared of you or the mob. I'm under the protection of the Lorimen and Carter's Guild.
You've seen that corpse in the ceramic armor there. Did his shitty little guild protect him?
Nah, you wouldn't just leave him out there if you...
He tries to light a fresh cigarette, but his hands are shaking now. The sentence simply ends.
The lieutenant turns and gives you a barely perceptible nod. I've softened him up as best I could. Now it's on you to finish the job.
Oh, I gotta go in for the killing blow.
Be careful. This man still got some fight in him. By the looks of it, it won't be easy to break him.
Minus one, go fuck yourself. Alright, but Kim gave me a plus two buff there. Half light. Alright, we're done for now. I don't want to fuck up this roll. Half light. If I must, I'll consume alcohol. Alright, let's go through the clothing again. Oh, what is this? Minus one. Shit. Oh, plus one. Here we go. Gloves. Oh, what's this? Oh, the windbreaker. Look at this. Matching outfits. We're taking it all the way. All right, what else we have? Don't worry about it. And then just making sure I'm not doing some weird minus plus on stuff I'm already doing. Negating. All right, now here we go. Let me go here. Uses left, 3. Amazing. All right, don't worry, Kim. This is all above board. This is what the police teaches you to do. Don't worry. They say,
Okay. Looky looking for something odd?
83% chance.
Fuck off again?
I know how to... stats. Alright, make him tell you what he knows.
Men like this only respect two things. Strength and fear. Time to turn up the volume.
Oh, I gotta scream at him. Show me your lorry right fucking now. Lady driver's lorry. Where is it?
Fuck you.
Oh, we're getting a face-to-face.
I'm not gonna...
We're gonna make out. We're gonna kiss.
There. His voice grows smaller as yours.
I'm gonna... What is it? Wait. I'm gonna fuck you for the rest of my life? What? Oh. Okay, well, this is getting physical, but it's fine. fuck it, I don't care. I'm gonna fuck you for the rest of my life, you understand?
Fucking homo cop.
A globule of sweat gathers at his brow.
Look, fuck you, man. It's some lorry down there. Green, banged up thing. I don't fucking know who she is.
When did she go away?
I don't know. I don't even know her name. She just rolls with the fleet and acts like a big shot. Some dyke, probably. I haven't even seen her for days.
Where exactly is her lorry?
Past the monument. Down there. The Green Temple. Now, leave me the fuck alone, okay?
I know how to get info out of people. I just tell them I'm gonna have sex with them. All the rest of my life, or something.
A small temple by the monument. Green. Let's get into that lorry.
Looks like he got his adrenaline up, too.
Right. I'm going. It worked. Alright, it was the gloves. It was the jacket. What jacket did I have on? Probably this one, right? Oh, well. If it's not, then this is a fine one to be wearing right now. Alright, search through the lady driver's lorry cabin near the monument. Bye. Monument. Here it is.
This green found A to Z contemporary. Is parked in the shadow of the ruins looming overhead. It's seen better days.
This must be the one he told us about, unless he was lying.
Lieutenant peeks inside. How are we gonna get this open, Kim?
Use the pry bar to smash the window. Open it from the inside.
Really?
This has been hard enough. No need to make it any harder.
First I'm gonna try to peek in the window.
The glass on the side windows is tinted and covered with dust. You can barely make out the shape of the seat and two steering levers.
Alright, let's get the, he said the multi-tool?
This green foul, A to Z, contemporary, is parked in the shadow of the ruins looming overhead. It's seen better days.
I'm gonna smash the window in with the pry bar here. 1, 2, 3, huh? No fucking way!
You take a hard swing at the window. A loud thunk rings out and the pry bar bounces back, leaving a tiny spider web on the glass.
You've gotta be kidding me. A 3 and a 1 must have just missed it. The check. Most likely. God.
Goddamn maggot. Drag your ass to the gym and do some reps right now. Looks like the window might be shatterproof. You may have to rethink your approach.
I feel like hitting it again might cause a problem. The window appears to be shatterproof.
No, it's not shatterproof. Give me that.
Kim's like, I'll fucking do it. He takes the pry bar from you and gestures for you to step back. Then, with little warning,
he smashes it into the window. Droplets of glass fly everywhere, shattering over the lorry floor and pavement. You can just reach in now.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. It went better than I expected. Open it from the inside.
Open the door.
The smell of cigarettes and perfume welcomes you. The cabin inside is plastered with old movie posters. Actresses smile from the walls. There's a radio transmitter in the front and a toolbox tucked under the driver's seat. Some tools lie scattered near the pedals.
Examine the radio.
Looks like the frequency dial is absent. It requires a key to work, but the key has been removed, likely by the missing lady driver.
Strange. There are so many radio stations saved here. Must be over 100 at least.
It has to be an advanced model to fit so many frequencies next to each other without blending them together.
Why would anyone need so many radio stations?
For contacting an entire fleet of lorrymen, for example. This is all shortwave, UW and UKV. Looks like we are dealing with an impressive organizational tool. The nerve center of a huge operation. With quite a range, too.
A 20-kilometer radius, at least. Perhaps extended by an attachable antenna that's not here right now.
Is there anything we can do with the radio?
Doesn't look like it. It's completely inoperable without the dial key.
What else is here?
The smell of 1,000 cigarettes, some dead actresses, and a rusty old toolbox under the seat.
I'm gonna check the pedals.
You wedge yourself under the steering wheel to get a better look. Seems like the few tools lying around here, a hammer, a pair of pliers, a rusty wrench, have been casually thrown there by the disorganized driver. But one odd detail does catch your eye. A piece of sandpaper has been glued to the throttle. Sandpaper adds extra grip.
Looks like the driver has glued a piece of sandpaper to the throttle to offer some extra grip.
Sandpaper? A novel technique?
Sandpaper would also rub off the pattern from the driver's right boot sole.
Yes?
He likes where this is going.
Do the honors, he thinks. Connect it yourself.
One of the footprints at the crime scene had an aberration. One sole was smoother than the other.
Which means that the missing...
Oh, look at us go! The lynching. Lieutenant's eyes light up behind his prescription lens. First the drug smuggling, now this. How deep does this rabbit hole go?
Now we know for certain who is the missing eighth person at the lynching. Do you think that Hardy and his boys could also be involved in the drug operation?
Not necessarily. Lady Driver could have kept the drug trade a secret.
You're right. But we should still go and see what Titus has got to say on the matter. Are we finished with the lorry?
The movie stars are still smiling from the walls. The radio transmitter sits on the center console, and a faint smell of perfume is in the air.
Fine. Let's admire the posters.
These are movie posters.
Why not?
Featuring starlets from long-forgotten films from the 20s, the teens, even the 90s of the last century. One of them particularly catches your eye. A centerfold of an ingenue attached right above the back seat.
An ingenue? Let's study it.
The actress is draped in a sheath dress, one of her shoulders bared.
Oh,
the
shit.
The faded remains of an autograph run across the poster. She's looking past the camera.
An exposed shoulder.
Wait, doesn't she resemble someone you know? But you can't put your finger on whom exactly. This is Tijon, a starlet from the dawn of cinematography. Less known for her talent than her tragic, untimely death.
What happened to her?
She wasted away in a drug den called the Door to the River, not far from here, on Boogie Street. A mixture of cocaine and morphine. She was afraid of the world, and the camera, too.
Enough of the posters.
The actresses and the rear actor all smile you a warm goodbye. A radio transmitter is attached to the dashboard, and a toolbox sits under the driver's seat.
I'm gonna pull out the toolbox.
A metallic drawer slides out from the seat.
Just to see if anything's interesting there.
Except for a folded newspaper.
Unfold the newspaper.
It's an issue of Petit Ferique from last Wednesday. A piece of paper falls out from its pages.
Pick up the note.
It looks like an article ripped out from a radio enthusiast magazine. Complex mathematical equations explain the basics of something called the ULAN frequency system. These formulas look oddly painful. Maybe it's the hangover, but they give you a headache.
The ULAN frequency system? I've never heard of that before. I know of FM, AM, UKV, but...
His thought trails off. Push in the pull-out toolbox, then.
The pull-out toolbox slides back into its nest. The rest is as it was. Radio, posters, a trace of motor oil smell under all the cigarettes.
Let's close the door.
You close the rusty old locked door.
Great. I think we got everything. A word, detective? Before we return to Joyce?
Yes? Yes, Skip?
All right. We've finished here. Let's quickly debrief and go over what we found, so we don't do it in front of the company rep.
Smart. Smart, Kim. This is why I pay you the big bucks. It seems like something police would do. What do you think of all this, Kim?
Honestly, I'm quite worried by what we've seen so far. The evidence seems to point to a rather extensive and well-organized operation. I'm especially intrigued by that radio transmitter, particularly the sheer number of stations it can connect. Looks like this alleged drug trade casts a wide net.
This means it's well funded. Technology like that, a major player must be financing it.
I'm not sure what the ULAN frequencies are all about, but they may hold some significance. Perhaps it's a better way to connect between fleets while avoiding frequency bleed, or maybe it's used to tap into RCM networks.
I'm not sure what the ULAN frequencies are all about, but they may hold some significance.
Listening in on your calls between you and your station, a worrying prospect.
And last but not least, it looks like the Hardy boys knew this driver, as we know that she was present at the lynching. This may be the union connection we've been searching for.
The probe and the case converged, he thinks. This was quite the find.
It looks like the Hardy Boys knew this driver was trying to launch. Will the RCM open investigation into this?
We should return to the murder case. See what Joyce tells us about the lynching. When we are done for the day, I call my station and suggest our narcotics department look into it. There are more than enough grounds to start an official investigation. Sometime later, when we are done here. We do not want to get caught in that.
He stops to think. What are you thinking?
The fact that one hasn't started already gives me pause. An investigation, I mean. Especially if the Madrid grouping is involved, and I can't imagine they aren't. It's certainly worrisome.
Corruption?
All the same, I don't like the idea of internal affairs descending on the matter. That won't help anyone either.
There's a part of me that feels this is the dumb person's question, but... I do want to see what Kim says. What about the movie posters? How do they factor into all this?
As elegant as they are, I don't think they are relevant to the drug trade.
Are you sure, Kim?
Don't be fooled. Desire always plays a role.
A lot of women there, especially for a lady driver's cabin.
Yes, well...
He doesn't say more.
Unimportant.
So it turns out this is connected to the union?
Like Joyce told us, yes, logistically. But don't expect to bust this open during our stay here. At best, this is an angle we can use against them, to other ends, as extra ammunition.
Meaning, someone as slippery as Everard won't be caught by a couple of cops and some stuff they found in some cabin.
Okay. Debrief over?
Debrief over. After you.
Excellent. Alright, so we have... We can report back to Joyce. We can also confront them about the drug trade. Two new ties. Well, not too new, but a new tie, and then finish that up, I assume. Let's go talk to Joyce. Let's go talk to Joyce. I'm still carrying this. Can put that away. Wait, got a minute? Does he want to say something to me?
I saw you poking around in Lady Driver's lorry. She in trouble?
The racist told us where the cabin is. We only searched it.
Still better than me, I guess. Told you there's plenty of others who'd tell on her. But is she in trouble?
No trouble. She's gonna be fine.
Oh man, that's like a load off my mind. All that stress was messing up my rhymes.
He chooses to believe what's best for her.
What's the plan with those rhymes anyway?
Oh, you know. Tommy Lee Holmes gonna be a musician. Sprechgesang, but with beats. I've got a lot of free time on the road to hone my craft.
The correct grammar is Tommy Lee Holmes.
Lom. Lom. Why Tommy Lom? Lom.
Tommy Lom was taken. My real name's Jerry Lafitte. Tommy's way better.
Mm-hmm.
It's more him.
All right, another question, actually.
The man taps his fingers rhythmically against his arm.
All right, that's all. Bye. Bye. To Joyce. Even though I hate her. Secretly. I secretly hate her. Well, not secretly to the stream, but secretly to her. I hate her. I'm gonna stop running so that Kim stops getting mad at me.
You're back. Good. What can I help you with?
I spoke with the Lorman at the roundabout.
Yes, my eyes on the harbor have sent word to that effect. What have you discovered?
Wait, where exactly are those eyes located?
It doesn't really matter. And I do apologize for the surveillance. Wild Pines can't afford to be blind at a time like this.
Great.
In any case, it's a relief to know someone has looked into it. If I may ask, will there be an official investigation? I assume you discovered there is an operation.
If there is an investigation, it will be part of an ongoing operation, subject to confidentiality. I am sure you understand.
Thank you, Kim, for telling her, because I would have said the same thing.
Of course, detectives. In any case, you've held up your end of our arrangement. I trust you with the rest. Now it's my turn. I wouldn't normally break protocol like this. But the situation demands it. If you don't solve this murder, I'm afraid we may have a bloodbath on our hands.
The words bloodbath sound cold in her mouth. They taste of iron and strawberries.
What was that about a bloodbath?
Yes. I'm afraid this strike may descend into a small-scale civil war, with possible consequences for all of Rivershoal West.
Since you are sharing, ma'am, this is also the RCM's worst-case scenario.
Then we're on the same page, as grim as it may be.
So tell me again, how are the lynching and the strike connected?
I have an indirect role to play, I'm sad to say. My employer experienced a momentary lapse of faith in me. In that moment, they elected to deploy a private military contractor as an insurance measure. They called it my security detail.
A momentary lapse of faith?
They were dispatched after I relayed the union's initial offer.
Every worker...
A member of the board. I tried to convince my employer it was simply a piece of rhetoric or a joke. They did not appreciate the humor.
Do you need a security detail?
Absolutely not. These mercenaries are muscle, pure and simple. They're meant to intimidate the Union into surrendering.
Who are they, exactly?
Crenel, an Oranese military company. As far as I know, three arrived in Martinez. They report to me sporadically, but they do not answer to me. To be frank, our relationship is deteriorating. They wear ceramic armor, have semi-automatic weapons, and years of combat experience. They also have trauma and stressor disorder, and no idea how to conduct themselves in an urban civilian environment.
So, what happened?
The story is, one of them, the Colonel, I don't know his real name, sexually assaulted a local woman while he was drunk and separated from his unit. This allowed some of the more militant Union members to subdue him. He was taken out behind the Whirling in rags and lynched last Sunday night.
Story is one of them, the Colonel, I don't know his real name, sexually assaulted a local woman. While he was drunk and separated from his unit, this allowed some of the more militant Union members to subdue him. Okay. What then?
Nothing. Mr. Clare refuses to let me into the harbor. I have not been able to discuss this matter with anyone there. The remaining two Crenel contractors carry out their orders, for now.
For now?
It's a smokescreen. In secret, they are conducting an independent military tribunal into the lynching. Once this investigation is concluded, executions will follow.
What is the nature of this so-called investigation?
Whether to execute one, some, or all of the Union militants.
It will be all of them. The decision is already made.
Sorry, I had to check something there. Okay, it'll be all of them. Decision already made.
Investigation upon investigation here in Martinez. Racing towards some dark deadline.
You've made a mess here.
It was the Union who strung him from that tree. My hope is that you provide a single concrete suspect before Crenel indiscriminately pick theirs. Simply put,
she grabs hold of the mainsail.
If you don't pin this on someone good and do it fast, they will identify and execute everyone present at the lynching. This, in turn, will force the Union to respond.
Ah, lovely.
The Debardeurs have over 2,000 men. It will be 1,000 to 1.
Have you ever seen a hornet invade a beehive, Lieutenant? It's not pretty.
The Serai's giant hornet, the world's second largest insect, can kill 40 honeybees a minute, while a group of 30 can decimate an entire hive of 20,000 bees in less than 4 hours.
Shut up, Encyclopedia Brain. I have some shit to deal with. Okay, the world's second. Let me read this again, though. I was just like, in my mind was like, oh, fuck, we're fucked. The world's second largest insect can kill 40 honeybees a minute. Excellent. Okay.
These men work in tandem using semi and fully automatic firearms. Their armor is virtually impenetrable to muzzle loaded weapons, even yours. Most Union workers don't have guns at all.
The muzzle loaders need to be reloaded after every 1 or 2 shots. The automatics every 1 or 2 minutes.
As I said, a bloodbath.
Isn't this a pretty bleak scenario you're describing?
Many bleak scenarios have already come true, Lieutenant W. Freighter Dubois. All we can do is keep the rest from going the same way. One single concrete suspect delivered into civil court, and I may be able to defuse this situation.
Okay, this is currently being worked on. I was like, I was trying to remember. What can you tell me about Crenel?
Not much. Their public resume is relatively good, as far as private military contractors go. I believe they were once called Downwell. They boast a long list of clients. Saint-Baptiste, Welchmann-Lorenz, Eintracht. A warning sign, however. The operations concerned all take place in third or fourth world countries. Guarding facilities, escort missions and such.
Meaning they're used to operating in war zones.
Yes. All the good conflict corridors, Supramundi, Yesut, the Seminese Islands, countries that don't have a good record reporting atrocious military conduct on their soil.
Okay, anything else you got on them?
Sadly, no. Before this happened, I had little interest in them. Now that I do, I don't have the resources.
She thinks.
If you still have access to the ICP's database, you could run a better background check than I ever could. It may take some time, though.
She thinks.
The International Collaboration Police, ICP, is charged with coordinating...
Oh, the Insane Clown Posse, I'm familiar.
...in complex multinational investigations. Their database is the single largest source of information in the world.
Do you know a lot about the inner workings of the RCM and the ICP, ma'am?
In my line of work, it pays to do your research. I was prepared to deal with the RCM. I did not think I would be dealing with a group like Crenel.
Could you contact the company? Tell them to call them off?
I have. And they will. However, these orders take time to reach what is basically a rogue unit out in the field here. Until they do, it's all on us.
She's being truthful. She is pressing them as hard as she can.
I might as well ask all these questions over here. Get as much info as I can. This feels, even though I hate Joyce, deep inside, ring her for any information I can get, I think. You said the deceased assaulted a woman?
Or he didn't. This is information passed on to me from some teenagers loitering around the canal. I cannot testify by it.
What did these teenagers by the canal say?
That the man was killed because he assaulted a local woman. I've asked around a bit. This seems to be the accepted story around Martinez.
The lieutenant consults his notebook, his eyebrows knitted in concentration.
We haven't heard any reports about an assault in connection with the lynching. Where did it take place? And when?
Last Sunday night, at the Whirling in Rags, the hostel by the gates. Supposedly, the colonel was drunk. Maybe on narcotics, too. Either way, he's alleged to have sexually assaulted a woman. Sometime later, a group of dock workers got their hands on him.
And who was this woman?
That's a good question, officer. I don't have the slightest idea. As I said, it's a rumor. About a rumor. In any case, it's what the colonel's remaining colleagues believe.
So this colonel, the one who was hanged, did you know him?
If you mean did I see him alive... Yes, but I did not know him.
His name was?
Lely. His service name. A nom de guerre, most likely. He wouldn't divulge his full name. Only one of them did. A bad sign if there ever was one.
Tell me about the others first.
One is a man. Corti, they call him. A nickname as well. The other a woman. Phyllis DePaul. Corti is the gunner, I believe. DePaul is a radio operator.
What would you say was his eye color? The deceased's?
She closes her eyes, trying to picture the man's face, then shakes her head.
I too would be like, I don't fucking remember.
I can't remember.
There's a pang of regret in her voice.
The lieutenant was testing her, asking a small detail first to see if she knew him better than she let on. She passed.
That's all right, man. Anything else? Nationality? What would you say was his age?
He was 40. Or 50. It's hard to say which. He had a combat injury on his lower jaw. It made it difficult to estimate his age or gauge his facial expressions.
Indeed. This matches the dental reconstruction we saw on the body. What else? Nationality? Accent?
He was Occidental, I think. Light brown hair. A mixed accent, Oranese, or Mycenaean, maybe. His injury gave him an accent all his own. In a way, it was humanizing. He had to learn to speak through it. Through the injury. That's all I know, I guess. I only met him once.
So where are the remaining two mercs now?
They've gone to ground, as it were. I don't recommend seeking them out. For one, they're almost certainly armed to the teeth. They don't have the same respect for the Revachol citizens' militia as I do. To put it bluntly, they think you're vigilantes. Ghetto savages. It will not be a fruitful meeting.
We still need to know where they are.
You're likely to run into them eventually. When that happens, I'll be in a better position to mediate if I don't appear involved.
Nope, I'm gonna do it. Where are these mercenaries?
One is obviously the scab leader at the harbor gates. The one chanting the idiotic slogans. He's barely maintaining his disguise.
That fucking guy.
The other has a vantage point in a building south of the roundabout. They were keeping tabs on you while you were canvassing the lorry drivers.
One must be the goon in ill-fitting work clothes by the harbor gates. The scab leader.
That may be so. I still hope you heed my advice. There's no need to kick the hornet's nest.
For all your talk of averting this catastrophe, the situation
catastrophe.
Does this not bother you?
Of course it bothers me, Lieutenant. But my hands are tied. How would my employer react if it appeared I were intervening on behalf of the Union?
Your concern may be appearances. Ours is keeping the peace.
Might as well say the other one I figured out, right? One is probably in a building overlooking the roundabout.
That would afford a good vantage point. In any case, it's practically inaccessible.
Where is your radio for contacting them, if I may ask? Do you have an earpiece?
Heavens no. I'm not an undercover agent. There's a short wave at the ship's wheel.
She nods towards the sloop. She nods toward the sloop's cabin. Another question for you.
I hope I can answer it better.
How much time do we have?
Until the executions start. Truthfully, I don't know. It depends on their progress identifying the members of the lynch mob and their impatience.
They don't report their progress to you?
Not on this matter. I'm afraid they consider this a personal initiative.
There's a brief silence. Seagulls squawk over the bay.
It's a matter of days, not weeks.
All right, that's enough for now.
I am sorry to have been the bearer of bad news. If there is anything else I can help you with, please ask.
Oh shit, can she tell me about the tattoos? Now can you tell me about these tattoos?
Of course.
Excuse my hesitation. Sorry. I'm getting excited for no reason. Oh, the mystery. I was like, who the fuck knows anything about these tattoos, dude? She reaches over the guard wire and takes the photo, holds it in her hand.
For about half a minute, in silence.
It was taken with a trigette not long ago. This is the man's upper body. There were no more markings on his hands or legs.
I'm gonna stay quiet. Observe the woman's expression.
Her mouth is relaxed. The accordion lines near her mouth vanish. The pearls of her eyes move slowly on the photo's surface.
What do you think?
Sorry. I was trying to see if I can read the web of interdependencies between these points. The stars.
She points to one on the photo paper.
I can't. But that's how you read this story. The points themselves don't have letters, numbers, anything. Their size, location on the body, and distance from each other tells you what they represent.
Like blooms in a pattern?
Close. Port cities. This is an Orinese map of the waterways, a sailor's tattoo worn by wayfarers of the Dolorian century, over 300 years ago. The sailors would mark their bodies to map their travels.
What is the use of this map?
The sailor's soul would use it to fly back home if they should die abroad. This is a sort of contraption to be reeled back in by. The silver cord, they would call it.
Who could tell me more?
His platoon members? The other contractors. Though I do not suggest you go and show them that picture. This man was their friend and comrade.
Okay, I'll be super vague about it. Don't worry. I got this.
Surely there are other people to ask about the tattoo. This is not necessary to complete the task, officer. It's a dangerous side task. Search elsewhere. Challenge accepted. I say we do it.
Nope, we're gonna do it. I need the information.
Do what you have to do, Detective Dubois. I don't think deciphering that tattoo should come before public security. But if you should wade into the mob to find out, I couldn't stop you.
Oh, we gotta fucking do it. Yeah, here's the thing. I'm too much of a curious person to not do something, you know? Also, fuck the scab leader. I don't give a shit about him. I'll fuck him up! I'll fuck him too. Just like the racist man. I'll fuck all the people that I don't like. I will fuck them all day.
We will be careful, man.
That's all for the tattoos. Thank you for your help.
Is there anything else I can help you with?
Again, not gonna let her know that I've talked to... we don't have to do this. That's all for now. Alright, we accomplished, I feel, quite a bit here. Let me see. We're not done yet, though. I'm not saying that as if I'm wrapping it up. I'm just saying that was it was a fruitful conversation with Joyce. Now, I do have a point. I do have a point that I have. Almost another point, too. It's tough. You know what? Just in case it gets physical with the fucking scab leader, I don't see why not. Why not? Fuck it. Sure. You know what? I'm not gonna think too hard about it. We're not gonna think too hard about it. Ask scab leader about tattoos. Perhaps another mercenary could tell you about the hanged man's tattoos. So-called scab leader at the harbor's gates. Won't count as one of the people informing you about the tattoos, but could be interesting. What do you mean it wouldn't count? What does that mean? Wait, oh, I misinterpreted. Oh, fuck. Wait, so then what the hell? So there's still someone around here that knows about tattoos that I don't know yet? Alright, let's do the confront the hardy guys about drug trade. And unless that spins off, then maybe that'll be the last thing we do for Disco Elysium today. Depending on how that goes, I mean. I wish I had a Kim to my Harry Dubois. Oh, that's the thing. In a friendship, am I more like a Harry or am I more of a Kim? I guess that's the real question, yeah? I think most people would probably want to be Kim. But not everyone can be a Kim. Alright, I'm sure this conversation is going to go well. Wait, what was the thing about this? There was a check on here, right?
Behind the dock workers, a ceiling height window. The hawthorn branches scrape the glass like bony fingers.
Alright, well that's not happening.
Looks like the circus left him, but the clowns are still here.
That's me, the clown! Titus does not look particularly happy to see you. The authority check is still... I should have put a point towards authority. Alright, this isn't gonna matter now. But the next point I get, I should put into authority. Alright? And I mean, it doesn't matter now because I'm saying it now. I'm gonna forget. There's no way in hell I'm going to remember that I just said the sentence. There's no way. There's no way. I know my brain. I know. I know what my brain does. Alright, well, I'm not going to say I've connected you to the Lohu drug trade. You were going to say it? Yeah. I know the limitations of my brain. I know my shortcomings. Fuck. I've talked to Joyce and Mercury hanged. His friends are coming for you. How do I go about this? What if I click, I want to talk about the hanging again.
Again. Just get the dead guy's autograph, since you're his biggest fan.
Good one, Titus.
He fawns. You murdered him just like that. No remorse?
How many people have you sent to the Shays? Ever felt remorse for them?
Shays Electrique is the method of capital punishment in Revachon under the Coalition. During the Suzerain's reign, it used to be the firing squad.
I could try now, and if it doesn't work, spend the point on it. Yeah. I would suffer any potential consequences for failing the check, but I could. I'm not super opposed to failing checks. But there's a part of me that would want, like, just maybe one more point. Although, maybe, do I have authority clothing? Maybe I could. I'm no language expert, but I'm pretty sure this means electric chair. I'm not a multilinguist. I'm barely a monolinguist, but pretty sure this electric chair.
Or send them to reunion to rot for 20 years for life.
He says it as if it were worse than dying. And reunion? What's that?
The River Esperance Correctional Facility, a military prison run by the Coalition, dubbed Reunion by the inmates. The origin of the name is unknown.
Honestly, I drink so much, I can't remember anyone I sent behind bars.
Doesn't remember them. He just forgets. Are you hearing this, Titus?
It's the best I could say.
May no use keeping a stiff catalog in your head. That's for sure.
He wipes his mouth with the back of his hand. No more questions.
About fucking time.
All right. I just gotta come out and say it. Guess what? I've connected you to the local drug trade.
Like hell you have. There is no local drug trade. This place is as clean as a rifle. Go back to Jamrock and ask the local junkies how clean your streets are in precinct 41 kilos.
We'll do that. In the meantime, did you know that there's an abandoned lorry at the intersection that was used to move raw ingredients for drugs from Terminal B to Jamrock? The person driving it was present at the hanging. It was one of you. We've connected the footprints. Detective, do you want to deliver the coup de grace?
Ah, the coup de grace, of course.
The thought forms in your head like a lightning strike branching in the sky.
I like that. You're right, there's no local drug trade except you! No, you know what? I'm gonna let Kim do the honors. Fuck it. No, do the honor. You've earned it.
Thank you. You're right, Titus. There is no local drug trade because it's all controlled by you. You're the drug trade.
You're the drug trade.
That's a mighty interesting theory. I guess that's what you would need to do, theoretically. A big, strong, state-run monopoly would outcompete the runs on the street.
Now, deep down, I let Kim say it, because in the off chance that I'm wrong, then I'm not the one who claimed it, you know? Always deflect responsibility in claims. Always. That is me 101. First rule. You know, if you were like a, I don't know, some kind of... If, let's just say you wake up one morning and you're like trapped inside my body. Like a Freaky Friday type situation. The first rule of thumb you gotta know is that if anyone comes to you, just deflect. Deflect, and if you have to just be vague. If someone asks you a question, just give a roundabout answer. Just make sure that nothing can be pointed back to you if you end up saying something that could have been wrong. You know what I mean? That's all I'm trying to say. It goes the same when I'm playing this game as this character, you know?
Yeah, man. Theoretically, that's what you would do. To get rid of the gangs, the dealers, even some of the junkies.
You would need good, trustworthy people to take their place, of course. Hardy men to run such a monopoly. For the good of the community, of course.
Yes, but that just sends everyone else to Jamrock, doesn't it?
You've just diverted the flow to Jamrock. You've made it our problem.
We haven't done anything. But theoretically, it has to be someone's problem. So it might as well be yours.
He takes a sip of his beer and smiles.
Titus, I'm amazed. Where is the same professionalism when it comes to other topics? You're doing great. I hardly have to interfere at all.
I don't know, Lizzie. I guess theoretical things don't make me emotional. Now, was there anything else? I was sort of gonna get my brewski on.
Not quite yet, Mr. Hardy. There were 8 sets of prints on the crime scene. There are only 7 Hardy boys here.
The 8th Hardy. The one who's missing. She runs the thing, right?
My answer is... fuck off. Mind your own business. There is no 8th Hardy. I run this goddamn scene.
And here we go. Back to the usual.
The woman sighs.
I know. Fatty walked on all fours. He's so fucking fat he left 2 sets of footprints.
Despite everything, the little man is quick on his feet.
Go fuck your mom, Dennis.
That's more like it, boys. You heard him. It was Angus on all fours. Anything else you need to know?
Alright. Well, fuck. I leveled up, though. Oh, I leveled up! I don't have to remember anything. Look at me. There's just, 58% chance. 58% chance. I'm gonna take off now. Do I have authority clothing? Do I? Authority. Authority is blue, yeah? I think so. Logic? No. Authority is purple. Purple? Minus authority? -2 authority? I think I checked this last time I played. I feel like I remember going through clothing looking for authority stuff. And I think I did not find a damn thing. What a tragedy. A trumpet's going hard. Yeah, this is, not working. Well, 58% chance isn't bad. But man, would I love, like, one more point. Alright, so we finished that. I do want to do the scab leader about tattoos. Of course, we have the meeting at 2200. That's going to be later in the night. I'm not going to be staying the night over at Whirling and Rags. I've got that shack that I'll be staying at least this night with, it seems. Authority. Secret passage. Fuck. This bothers me so much. And here's the thing. Again, I think I said this before. I could look up the... Let me make my way to the guy. Just so that we can wrap this up faster. But I could look up how to go about the secret passage thing. Because it doesn't have a one of these things, this might take some time. I'm sure I'm just missing something. And that's what bothers me. And here's the thing. This is one of those things where people watching this who have already played this game and maybe already know how to do this thing, they're just dying behind the screens. They're just looking at me, constantly bringing up the secret passage, and me just being like, I just want to know. And then they're just dying to tell me, but they're not going to spoil it, because if they fucking spoil it, I'm going to be so fucking pissed. But I just want to know. All right, when we come back, I was becoming feral there for a second, but I had to cool it just a sec. When we play this again, which might be Friday night, possibly again. I don't know. I don't think I'm going to be streaming tomorrow, but Friday might be a little weird schedule-wise, but we'll see. Whenever we play this next, I'm going to ask him about tattoos. And then I may try to figure out this. I may attempt the authority check on the Hardy guys, because that just seems like a thing. I mean, 58%. That's not too bad. We'll try it. We'll probably end up trying it. But mostly we're going to talk to this man, and see what happens when we ask about the tattoos. For, apparently, just for fun. Is this just for shits and giggles, maybe? It won't count as one of the people informing you about the tattoos, but could be interesting. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. I'm going to hit up BRB. I'm going to get some water and stuff. And then we'll play, like I said, probably just like an hour of Umineko as I just read that for a bit. So I will be... Oh, let me save before I forget. I got to do that. Man, I'm so paranoid. Oh, this is about to be finished. And we'll see what this brings as well. I'm so paranoid about saving now. Ever since that disaster from Valkyria Chronicles like a month ago. That was a disaster. All right, I'm gonna go sneeze and get some water, so I will be right back.